and welcome to Countryside Knitting. This is episode 150.
Yes.
But we made a lot of episodes in only Norwegian, so it is not English episode 150. My name is Merete.
And my name is Jan.
And we come to you from Averøy, as we always do. We have knitting, crochet, and hairpin lace to show you, and some inspiration, some memories from the summer,
yes.
And big things and small things.
Yes.
We knit a lot of traditional patterns, and we knit a lot in wool, but we also do a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a little bit difficult to say exactly what is typical of us. But we like to give inspiration, and we like to give knowledge as far as we can in this way. So, Janne, how has your summer been?
Oh, I have been to my eldest daughter in the south of Norway.
Mm-hmm.
And I have been sev bunad, shirt to her, and make some what they called, the bunad was too, don't fit anymore.
Oh,
I have to do it a little bigger.
You had to adapt it?
Yes.
Mm. I asked you about the same thing. Could you help me with my national costume? And you said,
no.
Because it's a very different type.
Yeah. Yes.
Mm. Mm. So I went to Husfliden, that's where then the guild is, in a way, and then they will do it for me.
Yes, I have been embroidery and sewed the bunad to my two daughters by myself. So I can that type.
Because it's you who made it.
Yes.
Mm.
Mm. But I've not made one of that bunad
I have one from Telemark.
Yes.
That's something totally different.
Mm.
And I went to Telemark to visit my parents and brothers and their family, and I made an English episode, so if you have watched that, you know what I'm talking about when it comes to bunad and the rose painting. And I also had this in the post now recently. It's about all the traditional, the cultural heritage, kulturarv, that I really like.
Mm.
And I was given a book from 1994, when the Olympics was in Lillehammer. This is not about sports. Otherwise, it would be not a book for me, but this is about weaving, knife making, and knitting. And there is a chapter in English, so I will try to make some notes and to give you a kind of a I have the words are missing, but I will tell you what it was in that book when I have read it,
mm-hmm.
when I'm finished.
Yes.
We have a lot of things that are, or I have a lot of finished objects.
Yes. My finished object is getting to my daughter, to my cabin, and
because you don't usually make things for yourself that much.
No.
That's very nice of you to give away.
I give away the most of things I do.
I try to give some of it away, and maybe they will have more later. Mm. I don't know. One of the things that I have finished that I actually was thinking about giving away, but I think it will be in my own house because they don't need it right now. That's the blanket. And I have been crocheting this since 2018. It's not because it's difficult, but because I am good at putting things away and not organizing myself to finish. This is a very easy pattern. It's the granny square, and I have used about the same colors, red, purple, and pink. Not red, but pink. And then it's wool, it's superwash mostly. And what to say? I sew together some in one direction and crochet together the other direction. I could have said it was on purpose, it wasn't, but it works. So, and I had another color, quite bright green, to with the picot ending. And this is only for if you sit in the front of a television or outside, and you can have it on your lap. It is not for the big bed. So it's finished. It's big enough, and I like it. And I used leftover yarns, and I still have more. I could make more of these, but I will not start another one in a while, because it took me so long to finish.
Mm-hmm.
But blankets, that will be a keyword for this episode. It's yes. Blanket.
Yes, I'm working on a blanket with heart, and I am crochet them in this way.
So stripes, I have, in a way.
Yes, 14 hearts, and I will have 8 of this finished. So I have some of them, mostly.
Because when you made these blankets before, you made it all in
one
piece.
This, but now I have done it because I can take them away and make it when I am a trip.
Mm.
So I have 2. And I have 2 in another color, and I will have 2 in this color. I get so far on that, and this is the main color, so I will have 4 of these, and the last one is here. So I'm soon finished. So I will sew them together.
So you sew them together at the end. Yep. Mm. And this is corner to corner. That is not a method that many people do.
In Norway?
Norway.
No.
But maybe small you know how to do it. It's in the US, I think it's a lot.
It's a big group in Facebook.
Mm.
In corner to corner.
Mm.
Mm-hmm. And I will make a blanket with soccer. And I will have 3 of this. I will have 12 together.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, 3 in that way and 4 in that way.
Mm.
So it will be to
it's
a bat.
It's for a boy.
Yes,
or a girl could be, of course. But it's for a kid.
Yeah,
that was the point. Mm. You know, girl, boys, it could be this is for a boy, but it could be a girl.
Yes,
that's what I
tried
to say. You have to be politically correct.
You don't have football girls in the grandchild.
No.
So that's what I'm crochet, and I have done something special because where is it? There.
Here.
I sat and crochet on this one, and I made a mistake here, and I just crochet some like this, and I think, oh, could I made it like this?
Because usually you don't have the open squares.
No. And I think, oh, I have to try. So I made this yesterday. And I think, yes, you can do that.
So a mistake led you to a good idea.
Yeah. Mm. I haven't seen this in any groups in corner to corner. So I don't know if someone had crocheted it before.
I don't know.
I don't know. So, but
if you have, tell us.
Yes, I will like to know.
Mm.
Mm. So that's my corner to corner in crochet.
I have a blanket I started some years ago when you taught me how to do corner to corner.
Yeah.
I took it out of the bag yesterday, but I forgot to bring it to this house. So I will maybe I'll be finished with it next time. Then I thought, do I remember how to do the corner to corner, or have I forgotten? And if somebody had asked me to write down what I did, I wouldn't be able to explain. But my hands remembered, so that was very good. I have finished some more things, and I think I will start with this. You are not very keen on alpaca, because
nope.
You are allergic, but I have to show it. I have one of my friends in Shen, that's where I was born, and I lived there until I was 18 years old. I have a lot of friends there that I don't meet very often, and this summer I was able to meet 2 of my best friends from the time when I lived there, and I wanted to give one of them a shawl she doesn't knit. So I made her a lovely leaf shawl, as always, by Strikkelisa, She's very fond of the green color that you can see here. And when I went to the shop, I found that green color in alpaca. That is why I made it in alpaca. And I wanted this to be a kind of a shawl to be happy when you watch and when you use. So I wanted to have a bright color in the leaves. So it's a bit ugly, pretty combination, I think. What do you think?
I don't like that combination.
I love it. And no. I think that she does. And because when I visited her, we was outside. And she had some the furniture outside that was mostly white. But then there was one thing in yellow. So I think she likes it.
Mm.
And I will send it in the post to her. I made it in 1 week. Because I went by the train and I had 10 hours of knitting. And this shawl is, I don't know how many I have made, but I know the pattern by heart, so I don't have to look for anything. I can knit without thinking. That's perfect when you're traveling.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Do you have, this time I guess I have most finished objects.
Yes.
But
I have been several lot. And I used old pillow.
Mm.
Old Norwegian tradition pillow.
I guess that there maybe have other countries have
yes.
About the same.
I will think so.
Mm.
I make bags, knitting bags. And in the backside I use wool.
Mm. And these are very solid.
Yes,
this
it's very
one.
Solid.
I really like this one.
Yeah. Mm. And this is, I think it is silk and it's painted on.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's
very different from the woolly.
From the old.
Woolly.
Yes, and this is a jacquard.
Mm-hmm.
And old
jeans
mm-hmm. in the bottom and in the top.
It's impossible to use them so much that they get destroyed because this
mm.
is really a quality,
mm.
strong
mm.
fabric.
Mm. Mm. So I've been doing a lot of that. So?
I always knit something from Sofia Kammerborn that has the podcast. I like her world and her way of expressing or the way that her universe. And I have been test knitting a little bit for her now. The last months. So what I have done a lot is these mini mittens. It's the soft snow mini mitten. I have made several of these, and this is one that I made on holiday. And I had brought with me some finul, and that was a very good thing because when I was there, she had a question if I wanted to test knit for her a mitten, and then I didn't want to buy more yarn. So I used what I had with me. That was not very much, but I could make this color combination that I really like. And my gauge is looser than her, so this is a little bit big, so I think I will felt it a little bit. They are called Between the Lines mittens. Stripey, quick, easy. I like them a lot. So I made this, and I made another version, and that is in green. And this is also finul and PT2, old. The gray one. So mittens, if you work from our place now, you can really work with big things in wool because it's not the summer temperature, but this is perfect anyway.
Mm.
So do you knit mittens in the summer?
Yes.
Mm.
And socks.
And socks. I have no socks going on right now.
Mm.
So I have finished these.
But I am knitting. Always knitting in my purse.
Mm-hmm.
I have this is a pattern from my own.
Your own design?
Yes, and it you can't buy it.
So it's in a magazine only in Norwegian.
Yes,
and the motif is owl.
Owl.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's for the kitchen.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Almost too beautiful to use.
But I'm using them. I like pretty things. So I have leftover, and here I will knit more of them.
Mm.
Knit more of lots of leftover.
So
I have it in my purse. And I always have knitting with me.
Or a crochet. I do also, but I usually have shawls with me. And I think when I talked about Sofia Kammerborn, I think I didn't, we had a Norwegian episode that never became English version.
Yes.
That happens sometimes. And I think that this mitten is something I showed in a Norwegian that I haven't shown in English. So it is musikant. It means musician. And it's classical, easy, and this fits me better than the glow and the mitten. So this is tighter.
It's two color.
Yeah,
at the same
it's
time.
Stranded knitting all over. So yeah. When I knit like this, the stockinette, it will be always be looser.
Mm.
But I use finul. I mean, finul is my go-to yarn. Yeah. I always, I can use them for everything, almost, and I love it.
Yes.
You want to show something?
Yes, I have. It's a scarf, but I use it to wrap it.
So you just take the diagram?
Yes.
And cast on more stitches?
Yes. And
zigzag?
Zigzag scarf.
By?
Scarf by Christy Cam. It's a free download pattern on Ravelry.
Hmm. And we will link to it.
Yes. And this is what it presents. I use... Lammul from Rema. And this is the color behind. And I have lots of color.
Leftover
from socks.
Mm.
So I will put in. Within. What is it called?
Around,
yes. Mm. With that and one with that.
Hmm.
So
this is really, I think I really like the color combination.
Mm.
It
mm.
was
brown is fit to all color.
Brown and blue.
Yeah.
Mm.
Mm. And I will have some other colors too. So I have lots of small
balls
left on.
Mm.
Mm. And I use them in.
But then
this.
You don't change. You have colors that are about the same. You don't.
No, I will change because you see here.
Mm.
I will have that.
But then you don't put the yellow into
no.
the.
No.
Okay. Okay.
So I will.
Mm.
I will change the color.
Mm.
And not think about it. I just take a bowl and knit.
That's okay.
Mm. So.
I have before I went on my vacation, I was almost about to finish this kofte, Størrelsvatn, from Kofteboken 2. I looked on the weather forecast and left it home.
Because it's hot in Skien.
Yeah, and it's not hot here. So this is something I can work on now. So. This is Symre from Telespin. It's mohair and lamb's wool. Just a little bit of lamb's wool.
Mm.
And I have dampe. steam.
Steam.
I have steamed
yeah.
the top because I needed this top down. But I haven't steamed it here. So you can see there's a really strange difference between. And the sleeves are steamed. I really like these colors and I like this yarn because I have used it a lot and I also went to Telespin, so if you have watched my English episode I didn't speak any English in the shop, but I have some recording. So I'm going to make the button bands and the neckline and then I'm finished. But it's the summer, I have had a lot of guests, I haven't had the time to do it because I need to concentrate to make the button bands even and to look well, because that is something I don't always manage. It's not difficult, it's just concentration.
Mm. Yes, I have been making some hard hairpin lace.
That is something that is, I think, it's absolutely, it's stunning. It's so beautiful.
Yes, I use baby merino and kid silk together, and I use a hand dyed merino.
Is there a wrong side and a
no? You no. don't have wrong side and no. right side.
No.
And this together, so I make one of each, and.
They are so lovely, and you don't need to have pink. You could make this much, but it will be rather delicate and feminine because it's very like lace in a way.
Yes.
So, but if you have another color, it would make another expression. I don't know many who can do this hairpin lace, and I tried to learn it, and I have forgotten, and I have to learn it again. You can teach me.
Yes, I like to do some of. My things that I can, but I'm not doing so often. So I take them up, and I have said, I see I have done something wrong.
I actually saw that, and that is impossible to.
Yes, it's just take it down, and it's not hard to do.
We could make an episode how to kind of cheat or how to adapt.
Yes, I'm good to cheat. I am very good.
But you're also good at ripping back and yes. do it again. I'm not.
Make it over.
I have a shawl that I started in November. It was a mystery shawl before Christmas, and Christmas was December was busy, so I started and put it away and couldn't find it. But now I have found it, and I'm almost finished. And I knitted a lot on the. I knitted this. When I was on my vacation. So this is Gro Tveitstøl. We know her. Mm-hmm. She has a lot of nice shawl designs, and it's very easy. It's knit purl and
yarn over yes.
and two together, mm-hmm. maybe.
And maybe no. SSK?
Yes, slip, mm-hmm. slip, knit.
Mm-hmm.
It's not difficult. Mm-hmm. And I really spent...
But only in Norwegian?
They are only in Norwegian.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a little bit difficult to show because
you have so short.
Yeah, I knitted when I was on vacation. I didn't bring all my needles. That was wrong. It will be rather long, but not so deep. And the yarn is Manos del Uruguay Fino. That's what did I say? Merino silk. I think I always forget what this is made of, but it's my favorite soft yarn. Now this is my favorite wool. It's hand dyed, so it has some green and some yellow tones in it.
Yes.
So next time this will be finished.
I have crochet my sheep blanket in small squares.
So instead of making everything in one piece, you have started to split up.
Yes, and I have made the pattern in Norwegian. But it will be, it's a short and it's a written.
Mm-hmm.
So you can crochet it if you don't know Norwegian, because it's a short.
You can use the chart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And there are some loose ends.
Yes. This is the loose ends. So if you don't like to weave the inside in, you can forget to crochet it. Just say.
You can make corner to corner with only one color. Then it will not be a problem. Yeah. I have also made two shawls that are in Kaffebrenneri in Kristiansund. I can show you maybe if I make a recording and maybe if I could do something in English. Because when I go to Kaffebrenneri, Yvonne and I, we only speak Norwegian because that is what she wants. Mm. So that's okay.
But so if I get with you,
yes,
we can take a bit with Yvonne in Norwegian and we can take a bit in English.
The problem now is that I have a rather slow life in the summer.
But Yvonne don't.
Yvonne has the opposite because a lot of people, a lot of tourists are there right now. And when things get a little bit more calm, I start working in school again. So we have some troubles to find a time.
But we have some plans to get it, us three together.
Mm.
Mm.
This is another lovely leaf cardigan, no, lovely leaf shawl. I have made several, but I think these shawl, I like the pattern, the structure, the leaves, and I know it by heart, as I said, so that is why I keep on knitting it.
Mm.
Is that okay? Or should I be ashamed of myself?
No.
I have so many nice patterns in my, in books and in my library on Ravelry, but this is, I knit it again and again, and every time when I am finished, I want to make another one.
My husband said a month ago, and he said, how many sweaters and jackets do you need?
Yeah.
I just look at him.
What a stupid question.
I just look at him and said, wow.
But this is, I don't know if I'm going to have it myself, or I don't know, but I wanted to try to use the bling together with the thin woolen yarn, and this was a yarn that I bought really cheap, that is typical me. They were not going to make that anymore, or they have started making it again, but they have another name, and yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But then what I noticed, I have a lot of this yarn in the other colors, but not in the red. So now, it wasn't even yarn chicken, because I, but I have, I put out the question on internet, on Facebook, and now, maybe in the post, it's already there, because I know it has been sent to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I will finish this rather soon as I can.
I think I have that pattern, but I don't have use it.
But
I think I have it.
We like different things, and this just happened to be my favorite. It was the first pattern I bought from Ravelry that was a shawl, and I just fell in love with that pattern, and then I use it again and again.
Yeah.
And the shawls are not very much the same. They look very different,
mm-hmm.
I think. But I knit baby blankets. I try to reduce the shawl knitting by making some baby blankets, but this, it is not difficult, but I need to concentrate. So when I went on a vacation and I was together with people every day, all of the day, I couldn't make so much of this because I need to concentrate. And I have all these markers, stitch markers, to know when the diagram is repeated. So if I forget to yarn over, I will easily notice, because that is so annoying, and it's not easy to rip up because of the pattern. It will be this is a merino cotton blend. It's Danish ecologisk somru from Kamarose, and we are going to make an episode. I don't know if we will do that in English as well, but it will be inspiration from Denmark.
Mm.
We'll see what. So this is Danish yarn and Danish pattern. This is Pixon, wasn't it? I forgot to bring the pattern. It's a designer who collaborates with Kamarose.
Is it on Kamarose's?
Yeah, I think so. I bought it in paper, but it's also in Kamarose's website.
Mm.
I don't know if it is on Ravelry. I haven't checked. I actually bought it in paper, like in the old days. I have another thing that I'm working on, because we have in Norwegian a make-along from Tuve Stua. They have more than 20 books about embroidery and knitting, but a lot of books, and this is the newest book that I know about, and it is knitting for boys or men. Gutta could be all
boys.
Ages.
Yeah, boys.
Yes, but still it's adults as well, and I'm going to knit for my child number 3. He's 19 years old, and he wanted something to have for skiing, like when going down
Telemark.
I don't think you can translate. It's a
special
style.
Because it called Telemark skiing in English.
Yeah.
Mm.
And Telemark is where I come from, so I didn't say no to knit something. And the pattern is called Christiane. Christiane is the old name of Oslo, our capital. Mm. And I think this pattern is a nice variation of the classical elements. And this I make in Charisma, so it can be washed in the machine. I think that's a good thing when I knit to a 19-year-old boy. And I like the colors, and everything here was in my stash, actually. I'm quite proud of that. So that is Tuve Stua, only in Norwegian.
Yes?
We have dyed some yarn. You have, and I have. Mm. I think maybe that will be the
last
part.
It's that's under the tape.
When we make these episodes, the Norwegian ones will be longer because we have more words.
Yes, we have some knit-alongs in Norwegian.
With Norwegian patterns. That's the easiest.
We don't speak about them in the English way.
Where
because you can't get buy them. You can buy them, but in Norwegian.
Yeah.
I think that's not...
We were so lucky to receive... there's a woman called Anne. She was a tourist at Hansgarn some years ago. And she also has a podcast. She had a lot of old yarn from her mother. And she had it some time. So this is really old.
Mm.
And we were given this box, and we split. You had what you wanted, and I had something. And now you forgot, because you wanted to dye. This is rustic. This is so rustic. I mean, even to Norwegian, it's rustic.
Yeah.
That explains a little bit. So it may look very sweet, soft, squishy, and all those things, but it's...
If you use kid silk with it, think it's...
But this is not going to be a shawl, even though, I mean, look at this. It's like candy.
Mm.
And I think this is from Spersa. That is the old breed. And I think it really... the colors are always very good looking.
Mm.
There's something about this. And it can also be used for weaving. So maybe, I don't know. Or maybe socks. For Sundays.
I will knit a jacket, and I will acetate fabric inside, so I can use it.
Yes, because it's lovely. It's it has it's kind of slick, in a way. It's shining more than I think more than like this. So it's lovely yarn, but I haven't decided what to do with it. And I have more, so I have, this is natural light brown, and I also have some natural dark brown. And you had a grey, didn't you?
Yes, I have the grey.
And you have dyed it into...
Purple.
Purple.
So I have purple and grey.
I have dyed more yarn, but I haven't got it here right now.
I have been using, not dye.
You just use it. I just dye.
And I have bought 7 kilo in my holiday.
Oh, you didn't mention that in the Norwegian episode. Maybe the English-speaking audience is nicer.
I've been buying Italian.
Okay. And what is the name of the yarn? Is it
Angora.
Mm-hmm.
Merino.
In a shop or a...
Yes, in a shop.
Mm-hmm.
But exactly. I forgot to take it with me. So I will have it with me the next time.
Yeah. But you can I have also bought some yarn that I I actually showed you what I bought in the previous episode. So I don't...
I have bought to this. I bought the grey in Rauma fabric sale.
In the factory.
Yeah, in the factory. And I have bought...
it's a factory outlet.
Yes, and I have bought this color and more of the gray.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So I have bought two blankets and one blanket more.
I only went by and I didn't stop.
Mm. And I bought skein with... You can knit a sweater in medium.
Mm-hmm.
So I bought five of them.
Oh.
So, and I like, I think they are like finul, but it's in Italian, Italian, and they was dyed with nature color.
Natural color. I want to try that sometime. I was just looking. There is a blanket lying here. I was because I thought when we you also had some baby blankets. I tried to make more baby blankets than shawls, and I found this that my mother made 23 years ago, and I have used it for my four kids. It's beautiful, and she knit more tightly than I do, so it's very... Because I think when I knit loose, everything will kind of be a little bit easier to tear apart. This is wonderful.
You have to knit on thinner knits.
Yes, I know. I haven't got a hurry, have I? Shouldn't have. We are going to eat. We have now made a Norwegian episode and this English episode, and we haven't eaten anything yet. So it's
we will eat and we will knit and crochet afterward.
So I hope that you have enjoyed this episode. A little bit of different things. Something I want to do more in the future is to make the summary of something more about the tradition, the Norwegian traditions, but I need some time because after I came home, I have had guests and then I have only had a couple of days to myself. So I need more time. And maybe I could make a special episode about in English. Then I have to practice my vocabulary.
I have this left.
What do you do when you're...
And I knit, knit one of this and one of this.
Okay.
And now it's empty, and I think it's not fit to one more. No, I think I
You have different other things to do, I guess.
And I take it out. Yes. So, no, I will just knit with this one.
In the previous episodes, you have commented where you watch our episodes from, and that has been very exciting to read.
Yes.
So many... to us very exotic places. So, and please make comments because we really enjoy it. That is maybe why we actually do this in English. Because, you know, it's a bit of a work to have everything out there in two languages, but we really enjoy the contact that we are getting.
Around the world.
That's so nice. So please comment, and we also have a Ko-fi account. You can give us a symbolic cup of coffee, and we have patrons. And in patrons, there are now quite many bonus episodes and some patterns, and there will be more bonus episodes. I'm about to make another one now from the last part of my travel. It is not only about knitting and so on. It's more about the farm and about everything else in addition to knitting. So I'm hungry.
Yes.
Yeah, so we will have to eat and then suddenly we meet again. So, bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.